Can you believe it's been 20 years since Martin Short and Jenny Seagrove first starred in the hit legal drama Judge John Deed?
Well, now the pair are reuniting in the new production of The Cherry Orchard, but before they tell us all about it, let's remind ourselves of their chemistry in the courtroom. Aunt Martin and Jenny are joining us now. Good morning to you. I mean, that's extraordinary. You look at that there, and it could be something we're saying, oh, that's tonight on ITV, but it's 20 years ago, and 6 years you did that together.
Yeah, we did. That's astonishing, 20 years.
20 years, 20 years. But 6 years together doing something like that, you must have some great memories of that time.
We had a laugh.
Certainly did.
I do remember one time in the courtroom when there was something happened, and neither of us could get the words out for laughter. And, of course, those courtroom scenes were forever to film.
Yeah.
And you're sitting there thinking, I've got to get past this because we've got a day schedule for this.
Everybody
and
looking at their watches.
Yeah. Oh, it was, I mean, oh.
And
I
you
can
thought,
feel
you
the giggles coming in Cherry Orchard, I have to tell you.
Oh, no.
Really?
Well,
yeah, yeah.
You've got Ian McKellen playing Fears, the servant, and he wanders around and it's a masterclass.
Well, he was here a couple of weeks ago and was talking about the play, which you're doing in Windsor. That beautiful little theatre, and so that it's a hell of a cast. I mean, that is it's a and also a very very famous play.
Absolutely, and it is a stellar cast. It's wonderful to be also in a company.
Mm.
It's not something that you get very often, and you usually get people together for a production, but a company is something different. Mm. It means that everybody, there are no small parts. Everybody has a part in the production which is equally important. And that imparts an extraordinary feeling, doesn't
mm-hmm.
it? A unique...
But also lovely to be back, back in the theatre.
Gorgeous.
Well, he and me, we were, I think, the first show back after lockdown lifted. Mm. We did Love Letters at Windsor, socially distanced.
Yeah.
And then we took it into the West End again after another lockdown had finished. Mm. So we keep being the first back.
And Jenny, your sort of schedule at the moment, Hamlet is still on, and then because of this company and how brilliant it is that everyone's together and it keeps rolling on, but it keeps rolling on.
Well,
and
we're doing Hamlet at night. We've got another, I think, five performances. And we are sold out, but every night they release some COVID returns. So if anyone thinks at the last minute, oh, I'd love to go and see Hamlet, then do, because I'm sure that we can
There'll
find a seat somewhere. But we're rehearsing Cherry Orchard in the daytimes and doing Hamlet at night. So,
so explain,
I don't know who I am at the moment.
I'm not surprised. Yeah. Explain the story, and because you play a very interesting role.
In Cherry Orchard?
Yeah.
The story is... It's this beautiful, vast estate in Russia in 1904, owned by the Gayev family. And Ranevskaya, played by Francesca Annis, comes back from Paris. And they're broke. They are completely broke, but not facing reality. Mm. And this wonderful character, Leparkin, played by Martin, has got the solution. And that is to cut down the cherry orchard, take down the house, and put up some little holiday cottages and... you know, rent them out to people and problem solved.
Yeah.
And my character, Gayev, who's Renyevskaya's brother, yes, you heard that right, her brother, I'm playing a man.
Yeah.
Shock horror.
He's away with the fairies, and so is she. And, you know, it's what happens.
And your character is kind of, it's sort of straddling two worlds, really, isn't he? Because his upbringing, he's done well for himself. So he doesn't quite fit into either area at the moment.
He has a very difficult way of existing because he comes from a peasant stock, and peasants in Russia in that time were slaves.
Mm.
But he managed to drag himself up from that and become extremely rich. Ranevskaya, the Francesca Annis character, has a very generous heart, and so she always treated him very well when he was young. But he doesn't know which world he belongs to. And so he's perpetually uncomfortable.
It was the fact that your character, Gayev, is gender blind, makes no difference, that attracted you to the role.
Totally. I'm playing Gertrude in Hamlet, so I'm mother to Sir Ian McKellen. And we've got women playing men in Hamlet. And Sean Mathias, who I think is one of our finest directors,
Indeed.
Just went, Jen, have a go at Gaia for me. And I went, oh, OK, why not? And he's a bit of an oddball anyway, so if you're going to play any man by a woman, you could probably get away with it with Gayev.
Mm. And you, how are you feeling about the first night? Because, I mean, with all your experience, you'd have thought by now those first nights would...
It doesn't change, Holly.
No.
I mean, after over 50 years, the first night is hell.
Oh.
And I wake up on the morning of the first night and I think, why do I do this?
You wake up?
Time,
most of us don't sleep the night before.
It's,
but I have to tell you, I'm going to embarrass him. He is giving a masterclass. That's all I can say. As is Francesca Annis, as is Cerian McKellen. A masterclass. I just stand there in rehearsal going...
It's the Theatre Royal in Windsor. It's a beautiful theatre. And your husband, Bill Kenwright, who's one of our best theatrical producers, actually, I was in a play that he produced called The Lodger.
He remembers it
In that
in Windsor. Yeah. When are you coming back?
A bit busy here now.
I know. Our loss.
Thank you both. Thank you very much.
Oh, good luck with it all the time.
Mind you, it was at that theatre that when I did my first night... and the family came in to watch. And I got into the interval and I thought, I wonder what they've said. And I looked at my phone to see what the texts were from the back of the stalls. And my father-in-law said, speak up.
You could always rely on family to keep your feet firmly on the ground, can't you?
Thank you both.
Thank you very much. That's Theatre Royal Windsor. And all the tickets are now on sale.